Are you struggling to cope and feeling overwhelmed? Hi, welcome to this week's Weekly Radish, which is one of three where I look at emotional coping and how we can develop our emotional coping towards the more positive. And just watch out at the end for how you can claim a free PDF, which gives you 6 key tools in better emotional coping. But for now, this week, what I want to focus on is the traps that we can fall into when we find ourselves struggling to cope with emotions. So I'm going to look at two traps and offer an alternative way to look at how we can view emotional coping. So trap number one, getting swept away with our emotions. Emotions have evolved to be acted upon, to be responded to, not to be ignored. And what can sometimes happen for many of us is that we get so overwhelmed and caught up in the emotional moment that we get swept away with them. And everything we do is as a result of that getting swept away. So it's worth reflecting on whether that's something that you are prone to. If not, it may be that you fall for trap number two. I'm not talking about toilets here. I recognise that when I'm talking about trap one and trap two, I'm not talking about toilets. Although it can make you feel pretty rotten, let's be right. But trap number two is the temptation when we start to feel emotions boiling is that we start to push it down, dam up, bottle it up, keep it in and hold it back. And that is a trap because the dangers are twofold here. One, we bottle the emotions up in a bid not to experience them, not to get swept away, and we crush them down. And in the process, we can crush down the positive as well as the negative and flatten out all emotions. And actually, it's almost like a still pond. Things can stagnate. That those emotions can corrode and change into something else and something a lot more damaging. The other danger with that trap is that they mount and mount and eventually the dam bursts. And we get swept away with them anyway, so we're back to trap one. So just reflect on whether you might be prone to trap one or trap two. And what I want to offer you is just a way to think about it a little bit differently. As I said, your emotions are not intended to be ignored. So let's just assume that your emotions are a bit like navigating the rough seas. Sometimes there will be calm waters, sometimes choppy, sometimes pretty rough. And like that little boat that's trying to navigate through, we need to sometimes roll with the waves, but ultimately navigate through towards an end point. And that's where positive coping tools and strategies can come in handy, just like a good compass and good navigation and sailing skills can come in handy on those rough seas. So, just some food for thought this week to reflect on how you're coping emotionally. Do you fall into the trap of getting swept away? Or are you somebody who dams up their emotions? And just let's think about how we can more positively navigate the rough seas of our emotions. So, some food for thought there in relation to how you manage your emotions. Don't forget, if you click this link, you can claim your free PDF, which gives you 6 simple steps to more positively managing your emotions. And next week, we'll be looking a little bit more into this emotional coping and how we get hooked by our emotions.